Hi everyone, welcome back to this channel. We can start learning the basics of computer programming from this video onwards. We can start with the architecture of computer, and this is the simplest representation of computer architecture, and it consists of the input device, output device, central processing unit and the memory unit. The system is always various processing data by this input device. And the central processing unit can process the input data based on the set of instructions they are fetched from the memory unit. And after processing, the resultant value is placed or transferred to output device or place the data, the resultant data back into memory unit sometimes. Sometimes the processing data is taken from input device, or sometimes it is available from the memory unit itself. Okay, so from this diagram it is clear that the input devices are always providing input data to the system. And similarly, the processing unit always pass the data to the output device. Okay, and this memory unit, from this memory unit, the processing unit can fetch data or instruction set, and after processing certain data based on the given instruction, the resultant value sometimes passed to the output device or sometimes placed back into the memory unit. Okay, now we can consider each of these unit in detail. The first unit is the input device. The device needed for the insertion of data in computing device is termed as the input device. These are some common input devices like keyboards, mouse, scanners, digital cameras, joysticks, etc. Similarly, the output devices allow the computers to communicate with the external users and with other external devices. Okay, and the common output devices connected with the computer system as the monitors, projectors, speakers, handphones, printers, etc. These monitors and projectors always supports output like video outputs, and speakers and headphones transfer audio type outputs. Printers are used for generating text and graphical type outputs. Okay. Next is the memory unit of computer. It's a temporary storage area, and it holds the data and instruction that the central processing unit need for its execution. Okay. So memory, we have two different types of memory, primary and secondary memory. Primary memory is used for temporarily storing the data and instruction, and secondary memory or the external memory is used for storing data and instruction permanently. Okay, so we have two types, memory, primary memory, which is also known as the main memory. This primary memory is a particular area in our computer which stores the data and information for fast and direct access by the central processing unit of the system. Okay, so note this point, the central processing unit can access data and instruction directly and in a fast manner from the primary memory itself. So the primary memory is used for temporarily storing the data and instructions which are needed by the central processing unit. So the primary memories are like RAM memory and ROM of our computer system. And the secondary memory is comes with larger in size, and it can store large amount of data, and it can store the data for a long period of time. That means it can store data permanently. Okay, these are some examples for secondary memory like hard disk, DVD, pen drive, etc. Floppy disk, etc. Okay, the secondary memory refers to the external storage device which can be used to store data or information permanently. So, in order to access data and instruction for execution by a central processing unit, we need to transfer data from the external or the secondary memory to the primary memory first. Then only the CPU can access data or instruction directly and in a faster manner. So before a program start its running, the program is loaded from secondary storage into the primary memory. Then only the CPU, the central processing unit of the system, can directly and in a faster manner can access the data from the primary memory. Okay. And also, the computer is a binary digital electronic device. That means inside the computer memory, the data is stored in the binary format as a sequence of binary numbers. Binary number means a sequence of or a number represented as a sequence of zeros and ones. So inside the computer memory, the data are stored as a sequence of binary numbers. Using zeros and ones, we can represent any type of data inside the computer memory. This is such an example for a binary representation. The storage capacity is expressed in terms of bytes. The computer memory, the storage capacity of a computer memory is expressed in terms of bytes. Okay. Next, we can consider various combination of this bits. A single bit of information is a binary digit. It is which can have values like logical 0 and logical 1, representing a passive or an active state of a component in an electric circuit. If the component in that electric circuit is in an active state, then it indicates the binary value 1. If it is in a passive state, then it indicates logic 0. Okay, so by making this electronic component in a passive state or in an active state, we can represent any sequence of binary number. Next is a nibble. A nibble means a group of 4 bits. Okay, a single bit can represent either a value 0 or 1. So such 4 bits together known as a nibble. The 4 bits can take value 0 or 1. Then as a byte, means a group of 8 bits. Okay, a byte means a group of 8 bits. A byte is the smallest unit which can represent a data item or a character inside a computer memory. Okay, nibble means a group of 4 bits, and byte is the smallest unit of computer memory representation. It is actually representing a group of 8 bits. This byte is actually used for representing data and character inside a computer memory. Next is the computer word. Just like the byte, this is a group of fixed number of bits processed as a unit, which varies from computer to computer, but it is fixed for each computer. The length of the computer word is called word size or word length. Okay, so the computer word means a group of fixed number of bits. For example, a byte means a group of 8 bits. So a byte is a representation of computer word sometimes and is of length 8 bits. We have 16 bit computer word. In that case, the size of the computer word is 16 bits. Similarly, some other computers follows computer word of length 64. That means it can process a 64 bit of information at a time. Okay, if a computer word is of size 16 bit, means the computer can process 16 bit of information at a time. A computer word is of size 8 bit means the computer can process, the processing unit of the computer can process 8 bit of information at a time. Okay, so word means, a computer word means a group of fixed number of bits the processing unit can process at a time, and the length of that word is known as the computer word size or the word length. It may be as small as 8 bits or may be as long as 96 bits. That means in different computers, the word length may vary from 8 bit as a minimum and up to a maximum of 96 bits. The computer stores the information in the form of computer words. Next is about the central processing unit of the computer system. It is mainly used, the main purpose of this computer central processing unit is data processing. The CPU is classified into two further units like control unit and arithmetic logic unit. The control unit of CPU, this unit controls the operation of all parts of the computer but does not carry out any actual data processing operations. This control unit is used for controlling all types of activities that are taking place inside the computer. It does not perform any type of data processing activity. It is responsible for controlling the transfer of data and instruction among other units of the computer. The main functionality of this control unit is to control the data transfer activity that is taking place inside the computer system. Okay, that means controlling the data transfer between input device with the CPU, memory device with the CPU and CPU with the external output devices. All type of data transfers are controlled by this control unit. This is the main functionality of control unit. It does not support any type of data processing operation. It manages and coordinates all the units of the computer. Next is the ALU, arithmetic and logic unit, the second part of CPU. This unit consists of two subsections, namely the arithmetic section and logic section. The arithmetic section, the function of the arithmetic section is to perform arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. All other complex operations are done by making repetitive use of this above basic arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. And the function of logic section is it performs logic operations such as comparing, selecting, matching and merging of data. So all the data processing activities comes under this arithmetic and logic unit of CPU, and all control activities, control and coordinating activities comes under the control unit of CPU. Okay, thank you.